गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 5। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर चैप्टर 2 एनिमल्स एंड देयर लाइफस्टाइल। नाउ ऑल ऑफ यू टेक आउट योर बुक व्हिच इज मिलेनियम साइंस जूनियर्स 5 एंड द पब्लिकेशन इज मिलेनियम बुक सोर्स प्राइवेट लिमिटेड एंड ओपन पेज नंबर 15 चैप्टर 2 एनिमल्स एंड देयर लाइफस्टाइल। लेट्स सी व्हाट वी विल स्टडी इन दिस चैप्टर। Concept mapping, introduction, animals and their adaptation to different habitats. After that, breathing in different animals, lungs, gills, spiracles, others. Feeding habits in different animals, herbivores, carnivores, omnivores, insects, birds. Movement in different animals, movement on land, terrestrial animals, reptiles, insects, frogs. After that, movement in water and movement in air. Then migration. What is migration? Migratory birds and animals. Hibernation. What is hibernation? And hibernating animals. Now let's start the chapter. Students, read it with me. Have you ever wished to be like a bird flying through the air, or a dolphin dancing swiftly through the water, or maybe a lion prowling through the jungle? There are so many animals and each one is fascinating in its own way. Every one of us has a favorite animal. Which one is your favorite? क्या आपने कभी विश किया है दैट यू आर अ बर्ड एंड यू आर फ्लाइंग थ्रू द एयर और जस्ट डांसिंग लाइक अ डॉल्फिन इन अ वॉटर और जस्ट लाइक अ लाइन रोलिंग इन थ्रू द जंगल? नो। ओके, सो देयर आर मेनी टाइप्स ऑफ एनिमल्स इन दिस अर्थ and each and everyone is different in its own way. Everyone has their favorite animals. Which one is yours? There is an amazing variety of animals on the earth. They come in almost every size and shape. Some have four legs and others have no legs. Some have wings while others have flippers. Some animals have hair or thick fur on their bodies, whereas others have feathers or thick scales. Now, there is an amazing variety of animals means that the earth is full of variety of animals, that there are so many types of animals on this earth. Now, they mostly come in every size and shape. They differ in size and shape also. Now, there are some animals which have four legs, but some do not have any leg. Now, there are some animals which have wings, but some others have flippers. Some are having hair or thick fur on their bodies, but some have feathers. Okay? Now, animals are found in oceans, rivers, forests, deserts, mountains, snow-covered areas, as well as in air. Now, the animals here, we found animals in the oceans, in rivers, in forest, in desert, in mountains, in snow covered areas, as well as in the air also. Now, the surroundings of an animal are called its environment or habitat. Now, the surrounding in which the animal survives, or we can say the conditions in which animals are living or they survive, that is called the environment or habitat. There are some habits which animals obtain for their survival. Okay. Now, the habitat of an animal is the place where it lives naturally, which includes favorable climatic conditions, availability of food and water, and protection for the animal and its young ones. Now, as I have told you that what are the habitat and the environment, it The habitat contains those conditions in which the animals are living naturally, or they are getting protection from the animal and for its young ones. Now, their favorable climatic conditions are there. There are some animals which live in water. There are some which live in cold regions, like polar bears. There are some who live in hot regions. So that's why their climatic conditions also change, and their availability of food and water also. Now turn page number 16. Now, the habitat of a camel is the desert, while fish live in the water. Penguins live in the South Pole, where they are best suited for or well adapted to that specific environment. Different features of animals help them to live and survive in their habitat. These features help the animals to breathe, eat, move, and protect themselves. Now, camel lives in desert. Fish lives in water. Penguin lives in the South Pole, where they are best suited or they adopted that specific environment. Then different features of animals help them to live and survive in their habitat. Now each and every animal has different features, or they have specific features which helps them to live and survive in their habitats. Now these features help the animals to breathe, eat, move, and protect themselves. Specific features of an animal helps them to eat, to move, to breathe, to protect themselves from any danger. Okay. Then let's study the different kinds of features and the life functions of animals that help them survive in their habitats. Now let us study about the different kinds of features and their life functions, okay, which helps them to survive in their habitats. Now, number breathing in different animals. Breathing is the most basic life function of an animal. We all need to take in oxygen and release out carbon dioxide. Oxygen enters the body and burns the food to produce energy. This is essential to do various activities of life. Animals belonging to different habitats have different organs to breathe. Now, first of all, what we will study? We will study about the breathing in different animals. How different type of animals breathe. Okay, now breathe is the most basic life function of an animal, as well as for the human beings or the living beings also, because without breathing we cannot survive. So that's why we need to take in oxygen and release out carbon dioxide. Then what happens when oxygen enters to our body? When oxygen enters to our body, it burns the food present in our body, which produces energy. Then this is essential to do various activities of life. So this is very essential to do various activities. Okay. Now, the animals belonging to different habitats have different organs to breathe. Now, जो एनिमल्स जो डिफरेंट हैबिटेट से बिलोंग करते हैं, दे नीड डिफरेंट ऑर्गन्स टू ब्रीथ. नंबर वन, लंग्स. द एनिमल्स विच कैन टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर अराउंड इनटू द ब्लड स्ट्रीम ब्रीथ थ्रू लंग्स. नाउ दोज एनिमल्स विच कैन टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एयर into their bloodstream, so they breathe through lungs. These includes birds, mammals, reptiles, and amphibians. And which animals have lungs. There are some animals which have lungs. Birds, mammals, reptiles and amphibians are those which have lungs. Now the lungs have a network of finely divided blood vessels which help in absorbing oxygen from the inhaled air. Now jo lungs hoti hai, they have a network of finely divided blood vessels, means they have a network of blood vessels which helps them in absorbing the oxygen from inhaled air. Inhaled air means the oxygen or the air which they are inhaling. After that, in lungs, carbon dioxide from the body is released and oxygen is absorbed. Once the oxygen reaches in blood, it is supplied to all the body parts. Now what it's saying, इन द लंग्स, जो लंग्स हैं उसमें क्या होता है, जो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड होती है जो बॉडी हमारी रिलीज कर रही है, द कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड विच आवर बॉडी इज रिलीजिंग एंड ऑक्सीजन विच इट इज एब्जॉर्बिंग. ओके, व्हाट हैपेंस, जो लंग्स होती हैं वो कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड को रिलीज करती हैं और ऑक्सीजन को एब्जॉर्ब कर लेती हैं. आफ्टर दैट said once the oxygen reaches in blood, it is supplied to all the body parts. Once it reached our body part or lungs, then after lungs what happens, it goes to all the body parts, it moves to all body parts. Then gills, animals which live in water have to take oxygen dissolved in the water. They have special organs called gills to absorb oxygen from the water. Now those animals which live in water, so they have to take in oxygen which is dissolved in the water only. The oxygen which is present in water only, that oxygen they have to inhale it. That's why they have special type of organs which is called gills. Now what gills do? Gills absorb the oxygen from the water. Now which animals have gills? The examples are fish, tadpoles, crabs, prawns, oysters and other aquatic organisms breathe through gills. Now aquatic animals breathe through gills. Gills also have fine blood vessels where the exchange of gases takes place. Now as lungs have fine blood vessels or a network of blood vessels, like that only gills also have the fine blood vessels network which helps the animals to exchange the gases, or the oxygen is supplied to all the body parts. Now see on page number 17, spiracles. Insects do not have blood in them, so their body parts are directly supplied with oxygen through tiny air holes called spiracles. Cockroaches and grasshoppers have spiracles on their bodies to breathe. They have a network of air tubes called tracheas, or within brackets singular trachea, present in their bodies. These directly deliver oxygen to their body parts. Now what are spiracles? Jo insects hote hain, insects do not have blood in their body. So what they do, So their body parts directly supply oxygen through the tiny holes present in their body, which are called spiracles. Now cockroaches and grasshoppers have spiracles on their bodies to breathe. You can see in the picture of a grasshopper also, at the downward side there are small holes. You can see. So that holes are known as spiracles. Now they have a network of air tubes called trachea. Now ये जो spiracles होते हैं, Spiracles have a network of air tubes, जिसको which we call trachea, और the trachea का singular form होता है trachea, trachea present in their bodies. Okay, now these directly deliver oxygen to their body parts. Now जो trachea होते हैं, what they do? The trachea directly delivers oxygen to their body parts. Now, others. Some animals are capable of living in different types of habitats. For example, amphibians are adapted to live both on land and in water. So, these have more than one organ for breathing. For example, inside the water, a frog breathes through its moist skin. While on land, it breathes through lungs. Other animals that breathe through moist skin are earthworms, newts, etc. Now, what others? There are some other animals also, like amphibians or... So, what they do? They are capable of living in different types of habitats. What, for example, amphibians are adapted to live both on land and water. There are some animals which live in land also and which live in water also. So what they do? They have more than one organ for breathing. The amphibians jo hote hain, they have more than one organs. As mammals and aquatic animals, they have only one, but the amphibians have more than one organ for living, for breathing. For example, inside the water, a frog breathes through its moist skin. While on land, it breathes through lungs. Now, the frog hota hai, what happens when it is inside the water? He breathes through the moist skin. जो फ्रॉग की जो मॉइस्ट स्किन होती है उसके थ्रू वो ब्रीथ करता है वाटर के अंदर. और बट व्हेन इट इज ऑन लैंड, व्हेन द फ्रॉग इज ऑन लैंड, देन इट ब्रीथ्स थ्रू लंग्स. अदर एनिमल्स दैट ब्रीथ थ्रू मॉइस्ट स्किन आर अर्थवर्म्स, न्यूस्ट एंड एक्सेट्रा. नाउ देयर आर सम मोर एनिमल्स व्हिच ब्रीथ थ्रू मॉइस्ट स्किन आल्सो. सो दे आर अर्थवर्म्स, newts, etc. Now, did you know, see the yellow spots? The blood contains an oxygen carrying pigment called hemoglobin, which gives it red color. Now, what happens? There is a pigment in our body or in the body of a plant, in the body of animals also, which is known as hemoglobin. What hemoglobin does? Hemoglobin gives its red color. Okay, now we will discuss the feeding habits in different animals in our next class. So for today, only this much. Your homework is to read chapter 2. Thank you, class.